Whoa! What's up, dudes and dudettes of the year? My name's Seth, and we are back. Give us more. Beep, beep, drove on the PS4. Did you see that? I wasn't even, like, ready to record or anything like that, but I am so, so happy that I got that on camera. That is insane, dude. Two Greater Dragon Caches. I had a feeling, too. I was sitting there. I was thinking, dude, you're going to want to be ready for this. You should probably open these in the video. And I thought, no, I'm not going to. Oddly enough, it didn't end up announcing it in the chat or anything either, which I find really, really strange. By the way, just as a heads up, kind of a little disclaimer, as you will, I should have it in bold text at the bottom of my screen, but I'm not going to. Instead, I'm just going to tell you that you're probably going to hear a lot of banging and tools and stuff like that. My pop's on the roof. It's extremely hot right now, and I have all the windows closed because I gotta get this video out, man. Like, seriously, so we've got two options here. Either I try my best to give this away to somebody, which would be quite beautiful because I don't want it. I honestly don't even care. But, it's a nice gesture, but actually doing it is a whole other story because suddenly then we've got all sorts of things that come into play as to how do we actually give this away, right? But man alive, the Golden World Spring Dragon. So that means that nobody's even going to be able to get this dragon until next year, because this is the one that you end up getting out of the pinata coins, as far as I know, right? Okay, let's go for an adventure. All of us together running around the carpenter's bench. I don't know why I said that. That was a weird all around the carpenter bench, but I did in a weird way. I don't know. So, you know what? Let's try it, okay? Let's see how this goes. Bear with me. Let's give this thing away. So, in order to qualify, all you gotta do is hit that like button, leave a comment in the comment section down below with your username. Now, this is where it's gonna be very important, folks, because as you leave your username, I'm going to get my friend Nintendo Gamer to leave a comment back to you and let you know, hey, dude, you've won. But I do want to point out that I do have a link to the Discord in my description of all my videos, right? I would recommend that you join that because that's where you're going to be able to talk to me more specifically, because there's like nobody on the PS4 version. I mean, there's a lot of you, but I don't have any of the officers or anything like that. Like, they're just not on it, right? So try to get in there. You know, I'm usually on during most hours for sure. I've just been really, really busy farming all of my fish trophy and stuff like that on the PC version. So whoever ends up winning, I expect to see a message from you. And then, I mean, I confirm that your username is the right one. And then I'll just hop on and throw you the egg. How's that sound? Yeah. So we've got quite a few things going on. Most of all, I have talked about this a little bit, but the Eclipse update, a little bit. I'm just kidding. The Eclipse update is right around the corner, dude. Very, very excited about it. There's quite a few changes that are going to happen with the new version compared to the one that I was making videos on before. So, you know, we're gonna see a whole bunch of different changes and shifts in power with the subclass abilities. And one of the things that I keep kind of not saying in videos is that, funny enough, you know how the Fae Trickster sucks? Get wrecked, Fae mains. I'm sorry, but the Fae Trickster is gross and boring. But not as much as the Knight. Let's just pretend that I didn't say any of that, because I know there's gonna be someone like, yeah, that's my favorite character because I like a character that has wings for some reason. Anyways, enough of the joke. It's dead already, old man. Fae Trickster's gonna actually become one of the big heavy hitters for Shadow Towers when the Eclipse update ends up coming out, because the Glitter Bomb that you throw stuns enemies, the same as the subclass ability is going to end up doing. So it really does actually give a lot of crowd control to the Fae Trickster, dude. And then, you know, once we end up getting the new Class Gem ability, which still sucks, it really does, but it's better than having a duplicate of yourself that ends up exploding, right? Now, if you do still have the Class Gem right now for the Fae Trickster, I do want to mention and let you all know, folks, get one. If you don't already have one, get one because you're never going to be able to get it again. Once they end up actually throwing the new class gem ability for the Fae Trickster into the game, the current one that we're all rocking right now, it's gone. It's out of there. You know, it's not going to be in the Everdark anymore. So if you can end up getting one right now, that means potentially you could actually be rocking two different class gems, which is very similar to when people kept asking me, Dino Tamer fans out there, when people kept asking me how come I had the triple shot with my Dino Tamer on the test server videos and stuff like that, right? That is actually because when the Dino Tamer originally first came out, he ended up having a triple shot as his class gem ability from the Everdark. And it was cool, it was great, you know, triples his damage essentially. And then a funny thing happened was when I told the devs about it, because they actually, like, they were talking about a completely different ability, the one that we all have right now, where, you know, you end up just, what is it, like lowering your ult timer or something boring like that. Anyways, when I ended up telling them, like, hey, what's with, you know, you guys are saying that this is the class gem ability, but I've got this triple shot. And then they were like, that wasn't actually supposed to be in the game. So they ended up swapping it out, but not before I ended up actually getting it on the test server. I should have kept my mouth shut so we could have all got on the live server, but the only reason I thought that story was relevant was mostly just because a similar thing is happening with the Fae Trickster, except it's kind of intentional where it's coming back a little bit later, right? Because with all of the, not the subclasses, but with the class abilities in general, the devs did confirm a long time ago, granted, that they were going to end up adding multiple class gem abilities. So they were going to be adding a second class gem ability, which I think is where subclasses came in. Because, the more recent new lead developer that's kind of taken over things has kind of shifted the game in a different direction. And I'm loving the direction that it's going so far. You know, it's absolutely great. Even the, the tokens that we were talking about, like, we were all skeptical, all worried that the daily tokens suddenly were going to be able to be pay to win, right? And they're not. They're not at all. They're far from it. Like, let's just go to the store right here just so I can show you how ridiculous this is. So, oh my goodness, I don't have anything out of the store on this version. You should really have a lot of this stuff account bound, right? Like, why would I end up buying this pack on PC and on consoles? Like, it just doesn't make sense to me. But right here, so these are the tokens that were from July. You get three of them for 800 credits. That's roughly $5. Like, that is the worst. Like, absolute useless. Like, it's almost as bad as the Radiant pack in terms of the value that you get. What value? You're just getting ripped off. Now, granted, you could argue that while you could buy those extra tokens and get yourself three extra boxes, or maybe you're just missing the extra amount, the extra amount of tokens to end up crafting the dragon egg or something like that. Not likely. It's not worth it. Like, it's too expensive, dude. I can't even believe that that's the direction that they ended up going. However, it is still, it is still better than what we all were expecting, because I was sitting here thinking, oh no, they're gonna make them in the cash shop and you're just gonna be able to buy like tons and tons of them over and over and over. And granted, maybe you can buy that pack over and over. I wouldn't know because I'm never going to get it. But the point being is that you can't. So you don't gotta even worry about any of that. Which means that the tokens themselves are not actually a pay-to-win system. Go figure. You know, because seriously, was really, really worried about all that. Again, sorry about the construction, folks. Like, I wish there was something I could do about it, but unfortunately, I can't. That's why I'm kind of perspiring so much, too, is because, like I said, I have all the doors and windows closed. Outside of all of that, though, folks, honestly speaking, the reason you haven't really seen me around in-game as much on Trove is because I've been really, really busy. Not only have I just been busy with, if you've seen my recent vlog videos, you know, I've got a new dog, but on top of that, I've actually been going out a lot more, just because I'm that kind of an active person, and I guess because the weather is nice, I don't really like being all cooped up indoors because we don't have air conditioning. There's no reason to. But Yeah, so I've been really, really busy with all of that stuff, kind of going out and doing things on top of spending every waking hour that I can trying to take advantage of the weekly double fishing. So on PC, you know, I'm really, really hoping that the next PC episode is going to be me at max mastery. I think I'm going to be able to do it because I have just been nonstop grinding my fish up. Like, seriously, you have no idea. I went from, like, what was it? I think the last time we checked, it was like 8,000 fish or something, and now I'm at 12,000. So it's getting there. You got to get 15,000 for the actual badge. Now, why is this relevant to the PS4 players? It's not. It's just something that's actually going on right now because, you know, like I said many, many times before, what I'm trying to kind of do is streamline what I talk about in each of these episodes. And I know that for some of the more hardcore fans that actually do watch all of my videos, know that I'm kind of repeating myself a lot lately. Well, not lately, but just kind of repeat myself in one video or two. And most of all, that's got to do with the fact that what I've learned is that not everybody is watching the PS4 version of Trove. Most of all, it's the PS4 fans. You know, lots of people are watching the PC series for sure, and those people might not actually care about watching the Xbox episodes. So that's where sometimes, you know, what I try to do as a commentator anyways, and this is just my own personal experience with it, is I try to explain something in detail in one video, and then if I have to mention it again in another video, I don't go into as much detail. I just kind of rush over it just so that you kind of have an idea of what I'm talking about, and then of course try to reference the other video. But yeah, dude, that dragon that we got at the beginning of the video, that's insane. So in any case, thanks so much for watching, everybody. That's all the time that we have for today, because I gotta go and record a whole bunch of other stuff today, like seriously. And hope that you've been enjoying just kind of what I've been doing with the channel lately. You know, there's also my merch store and everything like that. It's been an absolute blast for me, but it's been one heck of a busy week for sure. And I don't see that that is going to lighten up anytime soon, outside of the fact that if I can get my fishing badge out of the way, I at least will never have to touch fish ever again until they end up buffing it to 20k. Thanks for watching though, folks. Very much appreciate it. Don't forget to like, share, favorite, and subscribe for more daily content. Not only do you like the video just for the chance of actually winning the prize, remember to leave your username. That's very, very important. You're not going to be able to get the dragon egg if you don't end up leaving a username. But for liking, sharing, favoriting, commenting, and all of that stuff, you're actually going to be building up loyalty points that you can redeem for different rewards on my merchandise store, which of course is only one reward right now, but eventually there are going to be a bunch more. So it's still always good to over prepare, right? Thanks for watching though, folks. Sign on and stay epic.